友们，大家好，欢迎来到瑞视频，我是 Jennifer。美国少数族裔媒体服务中心召开线上研讨会，现在请看来自美国新闻速递的详细报道。
They are working to make sure that Alabama's democratic, institutions are as accessible as possible to all who live here. And districting and fair districts impact who we're able to choose to represent us. Here, right now, if we're thinking about quality of life, and offering a community that incentivizes people to move to this state or remain here if they were born here. And our elected officials and the institutions that they lead play an important role in shaping that quality of life that we experience.
Talk about this powerful word, which is redistricting. It is a word that has been not so familiar within, especially the Black community. And so our focus was to educate, to provide public education to those that had no recollection or any history of redistricting. We have been working with SESJ and different organizations around prison gerrymandering, is that ensure that all the inmates, which are people, are actually voting from where their home address is. And that decreases the population count within the census data, because it is unfair for those to be serving their time within jails and prisons and being counted as if they live there and they're actually housed in their hometowns, in their own city.
We know Alabama best. We know our communities the best. And by working together in our communities, by taking this knowledge that we've gotten, we can then see what works for Alabama to get a more equitable and fair redistricting cycle, to get more equitable and fair maps, and ultimately to get more equitable and fair representation. That is what we want out of this process. We are going to do this through three methods. One is there are going to be public hearings held by the reapportionment committee starting next week.
And I think that my observation of Alabama is that it can do so much more in terms of how our institutions, the media, the government play a role in how we are represented. What Alabama could do for itself is be more accurate, have relevancy, be accountable. And I think that that's the role that we play with the Alabama Indigenous Coalition, is trying to increase equity in our schools, in our institutions.
What's at stake for Latinos in equitable representation is that we don't have access to resources. We don't have bilingual personnel giving the vaccines. And as an organization that does leadership development, that does grassroots community work, we have pivoted, as most of us have, into something else. So now we are a bridge that's working with other organizations, with the Hispanic and Latino media, and churches and stores, so that we can host our own bilingual vaccine access clinic.
The Korean community needs more support and voices for us to fully immerse in our society.